So, let's remember a little bit how our inventory works, since we already have that. We already have done a few things. So, okay, when we hit I, we get the inventory screen. As you can see, we have our slots for our weapons, we have our cloth slots, and the rest is basically the, well, the items you can use. We can also have the spells for this over here. And we have as well rings and all stuff like that. Okay, but we don't have any movement to this. We can't navigate them yet. So we have to fix all that as well. Let's open up our level. And let's find our canvas. We have our inventory. And so on. Okay, and from there we create the inventory slots and we assign them. Let's close that. Let's go back into the game scene so that we also have the inventory, the canvas. Game menus. Let's open that up. Let's close the game UI because it's going to go. It's going to be a little bit annoying. Okay, and I think if we hit play, probably they're not going to be created. Oh, they did, okay. Never mind this, we don't have a state manager, that's why it's running an error. And in this case, it's the enemy, so let's just close the enemy. Okay, and we're just going to work with how are we going to navigate through these. Okay, so. To do that, let's find our inventory manager, which is over here. Let's open it up. So, okay, we have our item slot, which is basically the prefab, and then we go and create all the slots we have. And we also load those items. On setup slots, as you can see, we create the slots we need, and we panel them under the... Yeah, we not only just panel them, we also store them over there, and then we use get slot to get any slot we want from the slots dictionary. Okay, now I think I'm correct with this. On our UI slot container, we also keep the grid parent. We keep basically how many we have over here and how many we create and so on. Okay, and from this, let's see. I do believe we have them over here. Okay, we have our weapon slot UI, slot count. If we do a final references onto this, yeah, we create them over here. Based on our slot count. Okay, now the problem is we have to actually navigate through them. Not only that, we have to navigate through them via a controller, which is not really that simple of a thing to do. Okay, so let's fix the first slot, the first type of slots we can have, and we're going to create some, maybe we can just create some custom logic for each one of these. Let's see, weapon slot UI, and yeah, we do use this item array variable, target items. Yeah, I think maybe this is a little bit, it's a little bit more complicated than it should be. But we'll see. Anyway, okay, we have our setup slots. We're going to create an update method. And let's close this, this, and this. And let's do an update method. First of all, we need to know if the inventory manager is open. But if it's disabled, then that means we do not have anything to do with the update. And If it is open, we're going to have to go onto our input manager over here. Okay, so the thing is, we also need inputs for the arrow keys, and I don't kind of like that we go through all of this. Like, if I was to do them again, I wouldn't basically do it like this. So let's keep this as they are. And I'm just going to do a different method for the arrow keys, so it's a little bit simpler. So I'm just going to say public bool. Actually, you know what? Screw this. Let's just say UI inventory manager. Inventory manager. We're going to have this assigned, and that can be a little bit problematic. So we need to set up a UI inventory manager as a variable. So we're going to do that. Let's go under scriptables. Not a scene. Create inventory manager variable. Okay, that's not how you spell manager. Yeah, because it takes way too much time. Let's do this from here. Let's go under scriptables, variables, add new class, more behavior, and this is going to be inventory manager variable. Okay, delete this, add namespace. It's going to be a scriptable object. And then menu name variables inventory manager. Now public UI inventory manager value, we can make it non-serialized. And now we need an onAwake method. On awake, assign inventory manager. And yeah, missed that. And we can say public UI inventory manager. Actually, we need inventory manager variable. Variable and void on awake or awake variable dot value equals get component inventory UI inventory manager. Okay, and this will assign us the variable, which means close this, let it compile. Okay, so let's go onto our data. And let's find our variables. Create variables. And let's do inventory manager variable. Okay, which means this can now go onto, we can just go over here to the UI inventory manager, on awake, assign inventory manager, add the variable, and in here we can just find the input manager down here and assign. Yeah, we need to change the code back to the inventory input manager. Let's find this. Instead of the UI inventory manager, we're just going to say inventory manager variable. We have our inventory manager, and we can update values directly onto that. Okay, so we don't have to create buttons and all this. And I think we might just go over on another video. We might just go over and redo some of these so they are much simpler, because this is works well, but I think it gets a little bit convoluted and it's not really that that much ideal. Anyway, first of all, we need to know inventory is open. So if we already have this, I guess, so let's use that. And we're going to say, let's find first our input. So bool left arrow, bool right arrow, bool up arrow. Okay. And bool down arrow. And this will be input dot get button. Let's do down, get button down, left. Let's go with left and we'll see what we have onto our input manager. Okay, down. Now, if you are in the menu, if you're not in the menu, here's what you're doing. If you are, however, in the menu, and depending if you have pressed something, it's going to be changing and it's going to be navigating the rest of, yeah, basically your UI slots. So let's go onto our UI inventory manager, and you know what? I'm just going to change this and I'm going to say public void tick. And we're going to update this tick from the inventory manager. So I can also pass my input manager to this INP. Of course, this needs to have the namespace we have for that. And back to the input manager, let's pin this and this and close this, 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 and this. And down here we can say inventory manager dot value dot tick and pass this. Then instead of keeping this as, let's do control alt, instead of keeping this as, you know, internal variables inside the method, I'm just going to go over here, paste them, and we have to make them public, however. Because this is a scriptable object, we also need, well, okay, it doesn't really matter, we can make them non-serialized, but it's also going to just, the first update will just reset them, since you're not pressing the buttons down. Okay, but that means anything I have to work on the inventory manager can just happen inside my tick over here, and I don't have to go back and forth. So we need to have an index for our slots, and more importantly, we need an index for our slot containers, the actual slots, I guess. Okay, so let's see how we should do this. So, you know what? So here's what I'm thinking, to just simplify this a lot, and yeah, well, how should we do this? To simplify this, let's just comment this, and let's comment all of this as well. I'm just going to go with hard-coded positions, because yeah, I really don't care to over-engineer this. So to simplify things, UI slot, and let's see, I think we have them as item slots. Okay, it's going to be an array for horizontal, And public UI item slot vertical. We can also keep this as two dimensional array, and that's what we're going to do, but it's not going to be public because we wouldn't be able to actually assign that. Okay, so let's go over here. The first thing we're going to do, we need two indexes right now. Integer index x and index y, y or z, whatever. So horizontal will be the x, vertical will be the y, which means we can just do for horizontal dot length. Okay. Okay, and this will be x, and for y, vertical dot length. So slots x, y equals horizontal y, and actually, yeah, that's actually wrong. Yeah, we can use this, I believe, because this will only point to, yeah, actually, no, we do have one position though. Okay, and yeah, so actually, no, we can't even use this as well. So hold on. Well, you know what? Let's simplify it even more, because why not? And here's what we're going to do: public UI item slot, just an array of all our slots, and inside the item slots, I'm just going to go and say public integer x, public integer y. And when we want to get now a slot, let's see, let's comment this out as well. And when we want now to get a slot, we're simply going to be using, instead of the slot type, I'm just going to be using public UI item slot, get slot, integer x, integer y. And with this, we're going to be going through our entire list, or we can just use an index. Yeah, okay, let's use a dictionary as well. Let's say null, return r over here for now. And let's create a dictionary. Now, we will have to use a combined value for this, for the index x and index y, however. Or, yeah, okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to just mix it up, so it's going to be a little bit even simpler. Slots grid. Okay, so forget the dictionary. And then for slots dot length, slots grid, slots I dot x, slots I dot y equals slots I. Okay, so this will create us a slots grid. We need to initialize the slots grid, however. So that's kind of a bummer, because we can just have some set values. So we need to know from the start how many slots we have horizontally, which that will be public integer max x and public integer max y. Okay, so slots grid equals new item max x max y. Let's set some value. I believe we only have 5 on the x and around Seven? Let's go with seven and we'll see on the Y. So, okay, there it goes. And when getting back a slot, we can just do return slots grid X, Y. So, on to our tick, we're going to say if input dot left arrow, then onto our index x, we're going to say minus minus. If index x is lower than 0, then index x equals r max x. Okay, next. Let's copy the same thing. And if input right arrow, index x will be plus plus. And if now it's greater than the max x, and I think max x minus 1 is probably the correct value, that will be index x equals 0 now. Copy all of this. And let's do down arrow and up arrow. So this now is going to change to index y and index y max y and then index y and max y. And down here we're going to make it so it's highlighted the correct slot. Let's see how we can do this. And okay, we have the image is the icon. Let's have another image for the highlighter. And back to the UI Inventory Manager, we're going to store the previous slot. UI item slot previous, or let's just say current slot, but we're going to say a get and a set. Okay, to use the get setter, I'm just going to use UI item slot, current slot, and then getting will just say return us our current slot. And over here, we're going to check for if current slot is not null, then current slot dot highlighter dot color. Let's just use a public color for this, public color. Let's say normal color. Let's copy this. Highlighted color. And we're going to set that to highlighted color. But if not current slot, if it's not equals the value we're going to be passing, then change this to normal color actually. Normal color. Otherwise, if value equals the current slot, return. Otherwise, current slot equals the value and current slot dot highlighter dot color equals the highlighted color. Okay, which means we can just go down here on the tick and current slot. We're just going to say get slot index x index y. Okay, So this is far more simplistic than everything else we have done before. So let's see how we can set this up. It does require a little bit of a setup, at first setup, but yeah, I think it's far more simplistic. So let's go with this. Okay, I'm going to see my inputs, and from what I can see, yeah, we have pad left, we have pad right. Let's see, where do we have pad up? Yeah, pad X. Although that's an axis for some reason. Okay, so I think we're going to have to use axis because I was using, because these are for a controller. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to say, let's not do that. Let's copy one of these, duplicate this array, and I'm just going to create the keys for the keyboard, and we're going to worry about controllers later. So positive button for up will just be up. Duplicate this, make it down, left, and let's delete the mouse too, because we don't need that. Duplicate array, and then right. Okay, so there we have all of them. Let's go and set up our inventory manager. We do need to assign all item slots over here, but it's something that we can actually automate, so it's going to be a little bit even simpler. And instead of having this public, I'm just going to go under all the children we have slots and just going to say get component plural in children UI slot and UI item slot. Okay, and there we go. And this will populate our slots, and depending on all those, it's going to set them up. So let's go back into our inventory and equipment, and we can start creating these. This is going to be our first, and let's see. Yeah, so this, for whatever reason, this doesn't show in here. Okay, let's force it. Okay, we also need the highlighter, so the scripts weren't compiled. Let's see if we have any other errors. Oh, because we are missing this. Okay, so get slot, this can go. Minimize it. Okay, so this will be 0, 0. Okay, then okay, duplicate this because we do have the grid layout group. Everything is going to be placed in the correct order. So second, this will be Y, this will be 2, this will be, so 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, the other one, it's not going to go on this, because this is for the rings, it's going to go below, so we can simply go and add this. Okay, let's do this, X1, and 2. So there is our weapons. I'm going to go through all of them and just assign addresses. So I'm just going to pause to do this. Before I actually go through all of them, I kind of forgot to assign the highlighter. So here's what we need. This gives us the base. I think, yeah, I'm just going to assign the outline and we're going to be changing this value. So on the inventory slot, I'm just going to assign the highlighter. Let's also find the proper colors. So the normal color, I'm just going to go over this and find it and raise the value. And for highlighted color, let's go with something extra. Don't forget to assign the alpha. Okay, now I'm just going to go through all of them again and assign the addresses and I'll be back. Okay, so we're back and I went ahead and add everything onto the slots and their correct IDs. The only thing that I didn't add and I don't really care to add is the covenant. Okay, because the covenant, you can select it just like that. It will be a little bit different. Or, well, at least I think it's the covenant. I don't actually remember right now what this is. So, yeah, as you can guess, it's been a while since I played a Dark Souls game. I've actually played Bloodborne recently, anyway. And okay, so with that, we have all our slots where they should be placed. Now, the only thing is that these slots are not actually children of this inventory manager, which means we're going to parent the entire game menu under the inventory manager. Okay, save. We can close the game menu. And actually, if we close that, yeah, it's not really going to work like that. So I'm just going to bring the inventory manager inside the game menu and add the inventory itself over there. And then just simply close the, let's close the game menus. Okay, save. Let's find our scenes, menu, clear. And let's try this, hit play. We don't have the input manager, that's why we can't run it from there. Okay, let's see where is our reference, because we haven't assigned the inventory manager. So, UI, inventory manager. Actually, we need input manager. And we're going to assign inventory manager variable here. Now, here's one small problem. We need to first check if inventory manager.value is not null for us to run this, because until you have enabled the inventory manager, it's not going to assign this on the scriptable. So that means it's going to stay as null. Let's hit play. Okay, enable our inventory. Oops, that's our inventory. Okay, as you can see, we do kind of have a small issue. But why? Let's see. Huh. Slots grid XY gives us an issue. I think because we reached the end. Right arrow. So the get slot, yeah, it returns us. That was something. Oh, we forgot to assign the max X and max value. So onto our canvas, onto our inventory. Let's see. 5. I think 5 is correct. Okay. And we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's 5 by 5. For us, we are missing one slot, however, down here, so that's going to be an issue as well. Anyway, so let's go back to level 1 and open up our canvas. I'm just going to enable the game UI, and on the inventory manager, I'm just going to set this to 5. Again, I think the covenant will give us one small issue, but okay, we'll see. Save, let's bring back our scene, our menu scene. So I'm just going to unload this, hit play and try it now. game. Open tab. Let's see what this error is. Slots grid XY is not. So you're telling us that 00 doesn't exist in this sense. So yeah, that's a bit silly. Unless the start hasn't, yeah, I think the start hasn't actually init. So I'm just going to do this on awake. And I believe that's going to be the trick. I think maybe our slots hasn't yet initialized. That's why we're getting that error. A simple way to fix this would have been to start with the inventor manager open already. Okay, there is our error. Why though? Okay, let's make this to public so we can see them in the inspector. Or you can just serialize the field, whatever, it doesn't matter. Okay. So, on awake, it gave us an issue. Let's say start. And I'm also going to add a bool. Let's close that. Bool is init. And down here I'm going to say is init equals true, and inside our tick, if is init equals false, return, don't do anything. Okay, then minimize that. Let's compile and we'll start again, and I think this will be the, yeah, we should probably close the part, finish with the part. Start game, open up our inventory. We still have an index out of ray. Let's see why though. 00, yeah, that shouldn't really give us a problem. Don't understand why, unless I did something wrong and changed the value. Let's say weapon slots. We do have a weapon slots 00. Okay. X slots I slots Y slot. Okay, so I'm just going to set a breakpoint over here. Or let's do this. Actually, hold on. So, okay, so for this to work, we actually just need to just add plus one to this. But the problem is, I've actually set it up a little bit differently. So, left arrow, right arrow works fine. Down arrow, it's going to be plus plus. And then this is going to be minus minus. Copy that, paste that in here, and cut this, and paste this over here. Okay, so that whenever you press down, so that you're actually going down and not going up, because it's the opposite. So for this, it works okay. And let's see, I might have set up my slots, the address for my slots wrong. Let's try it now. We'll see. Okay, this works at least. This works at least, but I'm pressing right and it throw me to 40, and this should have been over here. So this is my doing. I've set it wrong. If I press down, it will go to 41, so this is as well wrong. It just means I just have to go on to my addresses and just fix them. If we press down, we can go through armor, we can go through rings. I think those are the rings. The covenant problem is already an issue, as you can see, because it doesn't have a different value, because we don't have any values over there. But for the rest, I think this works. Yeah, down for this doesn't actually work properly. So we need to fix, I need to also fix my addresses. So yeah, I'm not going to just stay on the video to fix the addresses, but let's fix the covenant issue we have over here. And we can just put an item slot, or in this case, we can even put two, I guess. Let's see, we can just say, yeah, in any case, we're still going to be missing one. So instead of doing this, we're simply going to go and say, if index x is not equals 4 and index y, I think it was, yeah, I need to check again. So we have 4, which means this, and we want 0, 1, 2, and 3. And index y not equals 3, and index, yeah, okay, or not equals 2. Then assign the current slot. Otherwise, don't bother with it. Okay, let's cut the debug log and put it above. Delete those. And I think with a first glance, this will work. If not, we're just going to fix it again. Let's close the game menu. No need for that. Let's clear this. And let's unload the scene, hit play. Again, open it up. Okay, let's go down. And yeah, when I'm over here, I can basically change. I have to press 2 times to go over the other side, and same with this. At least we're not getting the error. Okay, so, but when we are here, we kind of have an issue with the, yeah, with the up and down. So up doesn't actually work. When we are down here, so yeah, we're missing a value to this. Okay, close that. Let's see where we are missing that value though. I think it's because 2, and because the index is x. Yeah, there's something with this too, I believe. So on the else of this, I'm just going to say index x, set it back to 3 and not set it back to, not keep it 4. If any of these cases are this. Okay, I'm just going to try this one last time. And since this is going to work, yeah, I'm just going to end the part as well over here, because it was a little bit longer part. Okay, go down. Okay, and as you can see, it's still, when I'm over here, it goes back to 3 and 2, and it doesn't update to 3 and 2, it doesn't update the 4 and 2, so you can move normally. Okay, awesome. So I'm going to fix the addresses on the slots I have offline. No need to do this now. And oops, we get an error. Let's see what this error is. Well, I mean, we already know what the error is. Oh, this error means I don't have a highlighter assigned to one of my slots, so it doesn't matter. Now the other thing that I want to show is, if I'm pressing the arrow keys, I can still move with the player, and we don't want that. But that doesn't have to do with our scripts, it has to do with the setups we have over here. So if you go over here and basically remove on horizontal and vertical the negative and the positive button or the alternative buttons, you're not going to move anymore with the keys. Okay, so that's it for this part. On the next one, we're going to handle loading those items back onto our slots and then changing them and do the rest. As always, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, and if you like to see more stuff, consider supporting me on Patreon so we can keep making a lot more of this. I'll see you on the next one.